your fire back.
If you want your fire back, then
you must repair your altar.
Yeah.
If you want your fire back, his or her fire back in life. And maybe used to grow. Maybe used to live in a very healthy relationship with your wife and your husband in your past. And maybe your love life was full of fire, was fiery. Bonus if you sir. Yes, but today, yes, your fire is extinguished. You are no longer seeing the fire that you used to see before. Maybe there were some days you used to look at your daughter and trust her so much and say, wow, I have a well-mannered daughter who behaves, yes, whom people used to adore and love and wish to be close to her, or a son that people used to adore and used to be close to her and say in their heart, wow, I wish she could be, or he could be my son or daughter-in-law. But nowadays, that fire is no more. Yes, nowadays, that relationship between you and your husband is no more as it is as it used to be. The days the initial days of your marriage, anytime you used to see your spouse, yeah, you used to feel good, you used to feel wow, there she is, there he is. But nowadays, that thing is no longer there. Why? Because that fire is extinguished. That's why I want to talk today. I want to preach about the fire, returning the fire back. The fire that was once lost must be returned back today in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Maybe our church used to grow in those days, but now it's not glowing as it's used to. Why? Because that fire is no more. That fire is extinguished. Now we want to rekindle that fire today, not by might nor strength, but by the power of the Holy Ghost. We know where the source of our power comes from. And when that fire is extinguished, something must be wrong. Something must be wrong. Something must be wrong. The story begins with Abraham, the father of faith. And the Lord looked unto him and said, Abraham, I've chosen you. Come out of your father's house, because I've made your name great. You know, sometimes the Lord speaks as if he has done it already. And that's why sometimes prophecies come this way. I'm seeing that by the end of this year, you'll be blessed. And that year ends without receiving that blessing. But does it mean that prophecy was a lie? No. Why? Because the Lord speaks as if he has done it. Because he is in your future that you have never reached. The Lord is in your 2020 and you're in your 2019. So when he speaks as if, yes, he's in that 2020 year of your life. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
So the promise goes, here comes the story of Abrahamic promise. The Bible says, and he begot a son and called his name Isaac. And Isaac begot a son and called his name Jacob. And Jacob's name was changed. And he was called, Jacob was called who?
Israel.
Israel, yes, thank you. And his name was changed from Jacob to Israel, the father of Israel, the father who was to fulfill the Abrahamic promise. But here comes the story of the Israelites. Yes, they were in bondage. They were under the yoke of the Midianites. Yes, maybe the Lord promised you abundance before. Maybe the Lord prophesied unto you and said that you will make it anyway. Yes, but currently, your life is under the yoke of the Midianites. Yes, when you look around, you are seeing oppression. You are seeing depression. Wow. Yes, what is happening to me? The Lord promised me some years back that I will make it, that I will make my name great. Yes, now it has passed 20 years. I'm seeing myself in a jail of rejection, a jail of despise, a jail of no one wanting to hang around with me because I have nothing. A jail of ridicule, that's what Job said. Oh dear Lord, I'm a laughing stock to the youths. Yes, because I was rich yesterday, but now I'm poor. Look at my health. The neighbors whom used to adore me and the rich man in the east are now pointing finger and laughing unto me and say, wow, this man used to be like this, but now he's like that. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Maybe in your past, yeah, the Lord promised you a lot. The Lord gave you a very great ministry. Yes, a ministry of deliverance, restoration. And the Lord promised you a lot of wealth and abundance. Yes, maybe you used to pray very well. You used to see visions. And the Lord used to talk to you directly. But now, things are not working. Things are not working. You feel like you are under the yoke of the Midianites. The Midianites are the demons of the people. They present the demons of people. Yes, who come to eat what you have by force and leaving you with nothing. And at the end of it, yes, they torment you, they curse you, and make sure that you live in a cave. Yes, there are some people who live in a cave. Do you know it's a cave? Not a cafe, a cave. A cave is C-A-V-E. Cave, pango in Swahili, yeah? Yes, they take everything you have from you and make sure that you live in a cave and forget about everything that you do to make them comfortable. You know, the Midianites, when you want the Yasa wa Israeli, bila nguma, yeah? Yes, I want from you, I want from Brother Basil, Basil give me, Basil give me, Basil give me, and the day that you fail to give me, I curse you. The Midianic spirit. Amen.
Amen.
I feel the anointing. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, I feel like I'm burned. Can I take off the jacket? Thank you. You know, when I'm in meeting in this pulpit, you are my employer, the one who has employed me, yeah? So I can't do things the way I want. But I go open. Amen. Thank you. Sometimes you get a jacket, can't do it. You're my media lies when it comes. You know, sometimes when you want to fight, you don't have a jacket, you don't have a coat, isn't it? So I want to tell them, so come, Sasa. One on one. What else is here, son?
Amen.
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 Yes, the fire that used to flow in you is no longer there. Yes, there are some days that you used to pray to the extent of seeing God face to face. But now, no. Why? Because the Midianites, the oppressors, the tormentors, the exploiters have really exploited you to the extent of leaving you bankrupt. Bankruptcy means hitting or reaching the ends of one's resources.
What has it been?
Amen.
Let me tell you one thing. Do you know that now you are a supplier? You can supply material things or spiritual things. Do you know that? Hey, for example, prophecies and Catholic. You know, the day that fire will be extinguished, or that grace will be extinguished, yes? Or that grace will end or cease to not to work as it used to. You know, the very people that will hate him is the same people that used to help or assist. Do you know that? A potent backslide. Hey, ule ndugu, wala tulikuwa naombea hapa na wakia mkono. Wala na kutuwa ushuda huko hicho kwa makanisa. Kuna ndugu walikuwa jerele sana. Alikuwa na jita wali pes. Alikuwa na jifanya mtakatifu. Nili mpata kwa busa. Wow. Think about it. Is it true? And the people that used to help, that parent that used to live with her child, when she was down, the day you'll be grounded completely, he's the one who will stand and say, and the Lord looked at the hearts of the sons of men and said, their thoughts are continually evil, and I will shorten their life. Noah, make an ark, I want to destroy them. It's the Lord who searches the mind and tries the heart. Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
And that's why you may ask God, why is this person suffering? Why is this person died at 20? And there's another person who is living at 90. But when it comes to action, you see that person lives at 90. It's very arrogant. Yeah? Come on, for example, like President Idi Amin. He used to kill and destroy people at will. But he lived until his old age. Yeah? But when I'm in the house, I'm going to switch off. Everything happens together for good.
Amen.
Amen. And that's what the Bible says, that rejoice in everything. There is nothing like accident on earth. Imagine the Israelites. Yes, used to work hard. Yes, and used to plow in a foreign land. They used to plow, they used to cultivate that land and keep their foot in stores. Yes, and these Midianites used to come and visit them and plunder everything that the Israelites worked for. See, I don't get to my kid. Amen. Yes, so that was the Gula, then our then destroying the source of their provision mercilessly. Amen. Amen. Because once I'm here, I'm still a support to you. Now if you don't know that I'm a support to you, boom drop. If you don't know that your pastor loves you, boom drop. This game should come by Chicago police station. I'll be talking about that. Tell your crew. He's mine. What else you feel is that? Amen. Amen. So even if you hate me, just give me a space of existence because I love you unconditionally. What are you doing? But this Midianites, what a robbery, the cold-blooded hearts. Yeah? When they plunder everything, back to Mungu anaangalia and say, hey! I want to honor a woman. I want to honor. I'm telling you, before you curse someone, anaangalia, what are you benefiting from that? Can you benefit from that person even a single benefit from that person? Maybe there's a quality, there's a quality function, there's a quality matanga, sorry. But I'm not saying that you could have matanga. And that person and that one, the whole night, because he loves you. Consider that and say, God, yes, he may be evil, but the Lord that you serve is rich in grace, is rich in mercy. He knows why he contented me to this person. So Midianites, a person who has a Midianitic spirit can never remember the good things you used to do for them. They just want to see your fiasco. Your fiasco means a great fall. So that they celebrate. So that they get testimonies out of it. You know what testimonies? Again, it's a liar, isn't it? What else if you're a liar? That's why, all of me were offended. I'm a human being, yeah? So you know what you could say, I'm not going to strike because I have the power to strike. Isn't it? Yes, like I said, 1 minute. Because I believe I'm a man, I'm going to say, isn't it? But now, at the end of it, now I'm a man of God. What will I strike that person? I'm still alive. I forgive and forget. I don't hold grudges, by the way. I don't hold anything, let me tell you. I will still pray for you and I will bless you. Why? Because kama Mungu yuwala to judge na makosa ile tunafanya, no one will be alive today. And once you have that ministry of God, you are representing God on earth. Behave like him. That's why Paul said somewhere, imitate me as I imitate Christ. Not just me, I'm stuck there. Because I'm a human being. If you imitate me as a human being, you are a failure. You are a loser. But if you imitate Tony, as Tony imitates Christ, you will succeed.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Yeah, you may want to the Lord to use you, the anointing that is in me. It's good. Yes? But don't look Tony. Look unto that giver of that anointing. Because that is the source of Tony's anointing. And it's the giver of this anointing. So if you look Tony through the eyes of Jesus Christ, you make it. But if you look Tony through the eyes of sons of men, you lose it. And you lose it completely. Why? Because Tony is just a human being like you, who was born in a family of sexual perversive generations, of witches, of magicians, of... For example, mtoto wangu ni mgonjwa. Sisi wanungia tunawashanga watoto na bangi. Isn't it? Ndiyo watoto wetu wakuu wapone. Is it true? Ndiyo mtu akiangalia mroko na macho mbaya. Iyo macho imrudie. Iyo ni vema ya kuingiza na niyo mtoto, because the only spiritual protection is the Holy Spirit. Anything apart from it is garbage. Don't take it. So now we have a pastor full of demons. They only put demon in Jesus. It is a legal ground. It is a legal ground demon. Legal ground demon. Legal demon in my Jesus. So we take a pastor who has a baby. Yeah? Do you know what happens? Light and darkness cannot stand. Yeah? Is that true?
Yes.
So your daughter, angaza kosa kukufa za hiyo. Lakini maisha yake itakuwa frustrating. Mpaka ile sifa atakufa. That's what is happening to some of us. Why? Because tulioshwa na madawa. Si tulioshwa na madawa. Kuna kazi ile tulikuwa tunaenda tulikuwa taimba. Madawa ni lioga ni sabe. Sabe. Madawa ni lioga ni sabe. The dawas that we use came from the knowledge and wisdom of Egypt, as you have been taught here in the morning. And this knowledge of Egypt is a paganistic knowledge. Yes, that works as deposit or antennas of demons in our lives. Amen.
Amen.
60,000. But that man who came here, I'm like 15 shillings. You know, I think I 20 shillings. He looks like 15 shillings kind of a person. Why? Madawa, you need to bring the kili, you need to bring the money to pay the shule, you need to bring the pay what you have to pay, isn't it? So at the end of the day, it's not just that we are going to get the yako. Now what you want, isn't it? So we are talking about men. You get the opposite from what you used to get from it. Come on, you know, I am a pansy, you have a hatred beyond measures. Come on, you have protection, you have a loophole to attack. Allergy, cancer, diabetes, fibroids. Yeah? At the end of the day, yeah? The Bible says that he who gets well and not by right, it will leave him, and at the end of the day, he will die like a fool. That's why we have to be coming to this church very early in the morning and pray and tell God, we did these things without knowledge. To leave some people who are willing to be. We need repentance. Maybe our parents did these things unto us, and they're still doing them because they're still in the village. And people are advising them to do these things unto us. That's why we are grounded. Am I making sense?
Yes.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
Job na school nikuwa na mtu mwingine. Nani? Yeye mpaka anaenda lipata. First class honor ya mathematics Nairobi University. No? Inaitwa The Nairobi University. Nairobi University Kenya. Ndio the university inaitwa The Nairobi University. It's a great boy university. It's a university. Isn't it? But the first class honor in mathematics in The Nairobi University. But Ujaman is a fanakazi kwa bank, kwa insurance, anywhere. Anyway, anything ya kwa serikali na patwe Ministry of Finance. Because he's a mathematician, isn't it? But do you know what that person does for a living? Car wash. Yeah, car. Now you can see yake, he's employed in that car wash. And he was in a daily kazi mepatikana. Akira zimeo kazi mchana ni kidongo, itani waste your time. Car wash. Why? Why? Mama yake madawa, yeye akienda shule. Chukua dawa ili amsaidie ku pass exam. Yes, ali pass exam kama na pass first class honor. But you will see it, but will not. The blessings of God makes one rich. And he has no sorrows to eat. But the blessings of demons, I'm telling you, you must pay for. They ask the slave queens. Well, they don't have a kitui. They are partly sponsors of the tumbo, isn't it? Yeah? At the end of the day, cancer. Cancer that will be here I am. Yes, they will have a sinus. I'll not take you out of Karen, but cancer. Colon cancer. Could I forget the slave that I had the Kabarua before I had coffee? And I said, my own is vanity. I used to enjoy good cars. I used to fly with aeroplanes like just anything, like a bicycle. Yeah? You know, I people on social media. Yeah? A slave in somewhere I was supposed to. As I say, you guys go back moja moja kwa kichwa spiky, eh? Because now the money you have, the machines you have, but you are going to die. So prepare the bottles of your heart. So she's preaching the gospel, but at the end of it, She can go to hell and face the wrath of her demons. Well, a man's heart is not measured by the abundance of things. That's what Jesus Christ said somewhere, isn't it? But by heart. See? What is in your heart is what defines you. You may not suffer today, but suffer in Christ Jesus. In holiness and preciousness. Yes, at the end of the day, you will make it without stress. And the peace that surpasses all peace shall follow you. So someone's fire is extinguished because of the sins of their mothers, because of the Egyptian knowledge that that person has. I prayed, but no, in our tradition, we do this. We pray, but in loyal tradition, there are some people who go to circumcise their children in the bush. They're doing all sorts of rituals. Yeah, sending demons, thousands and thousands of demons to their children. That's why they can't glow. But this man looks like a moron. Because no one is attracted to him. No one can be attracted to a demon. Can you be attracted to a demon? And that's why I'm not going to go a gang. Because you can't be attracted to a demon. The repercussions of a demon, well, it's just like sleeping with a crab in your bed. A little crab. Do you know how a crab looks like? A giant crab. Why are our fire being extinguished in life? Why is that Israelic fire was extinguished and they are finding themselves living under oppression and suppression in the hands of the Midianites? Why is it that you used to sing very well, but that anointing is no more? Let me tell you one thing. With the Pentecostal anointing. So I'm not talking about theological anointing. I'm talking about Pentecostal anointing that is here in this church. Let me tell you one thing with this. Once unaanza kumess, slowly by slowly, alafu unakosa kufanya kutubu na kuingia kwa utakatifu as it is supposed to be. What's the good that we are paying? I don't want to tell you people that some things I can stand here and come to get you in here. Jesus, not a window only to see. Say, well, Pastor, I'm here. Is it true? It doesn't come to make sense. Was a one person say, well, I'm going to get you in here. No, don't go. You're a person that I'm going to go. Who said, may I use a man again to get you in here? Well, isn't it? See, don't know the testimony of that man. And you buy 8,000, isn't it? And you 3,000, say 1,800 apple. Why did you want to see them? You can't see them. Isn't it? Simple instruction. So where was I? Yes, once you begin messing up, sometimes the anointing cannot be lifted. Inakwanga lifted pole pole sometimes. Yeah? Because anointing ikuja inakujanga pole pole. Inakujanga in years before the Lord. Yes, waiting upon the Lord, praying and serving God. So you don't know, piss off. So you don't know, discouraged because I'm not going to charge. Yeah? Yeah, you're anointing inakujanga pole pole. Isn't it? That's what we pray on a daily basis. Fill me. You can't be satisfied with the anointing of the Holy Spirit. So it is the same when you start seeing me. When you start seeing me, I'm not even going to talk about it. When it's getting a little bigger, it's getting a little more sharp. You just want to get a talker. That's my mom and then she won't get this way. She can be a zoom boom for day. But it's because of God, it's not because of me. They don't even talk about it because of sin. Yeah? The Israelites sin against the Lord. So the fire comes up with Zima Pole. Nikama Kuni, Umeziega Pamoja. They'll start dying, the embers like kuni moja, zitaanza kukufa moja kwa moja, moja mpaka hiyo moto izime. So hiyo moto mpaka isongeshwe, kuni mpaka isongeshwe ndio kideri hivi, isn't it? So what happens when you start singing? inazuia hiyo power ya kusongesha kumi pamoja. Hmm? So that's why unapata mtu alikuwa anaimba very powerful. Na alikuwa akishika mic kila mtu anasema wow. Is that true? Mtu alikuwa anahubiri mpaka mtu anasema hallelujah. Someone used to prophesy mpaka mtu anasema true man of God, that is true. But inafika mahali yeye anaitika inaendaga. Why? Because of sin. Bila huyo mtu kujua. Yeah? So ikifika mahali huyo mtu anabakia ameokoka but no anointing. So that person becomes a stronghold amid this sheep. Because once the anointing leaves, the kingdom of darkness comes and invests in that person. Is it true? Mm-hmm. Hey, this person was a pastor. He used to pray. No, no, but I'm to come away. Such people, they don't have power to bless, but to curse. You know, the anointing of God, it's only God who can bless. Do you know that? Bwana asifiwe sana. Unajua kuna siku nilikuwa naona documentary ya kanisa fulani ya Rome kwa YouTube. Naona hii kanisa kuna wachungaji na iko na watu. But the people who go to that church are poor. Very poor. And that church is somewhere in Kenya, Kawangware. Isn't it? And they don't pray, wanaomba. Eh? But they can't bless anybody in that congregation. But they pray very powerfully. Nani wazee wamevaa nguo za white na nguo za Israeli zimeandikwa Israeli. Hii ndio watu wanaenda Israeli kupoi. But they can't bless. And then they're men of God. Why? Because they call upon the name of the Lord. Yes, they go to church. Yes, they go to church. But the anointing of God is not in them. And they have a very big congregation, isn't it? So ili tu wao fanya tu ni moja. Kuna hali. Niliona mshirika kiende kwa kanisa ya Mweresa. Do you know Mweresa? Hmm? Ule mshirika ni kama laani. Na hakika saa hii. Ukiangalia maisha yake amepotelea kwa pesa. Hizo ni testimonies for that church. Yeah? And then it's a very big church. And they believe in curses from their leaders. Hey, when the congregation, mshirika kisikia pasta ata kumlaani. Anza kuja hata na loo na mbati. Hmm? Because they believe curses works very fast than blessings. Mshia una kanisa kama hizi. A church that can't even afford a broom ya 20 shilling. Na watu ni wengi hivi. Why? Because there is no blessing there. Where there is no God, there is no blessing. That's why a wish can never bless you. That's why Waisraeli wangeweza barikiwa in Egypt. Never. So here comes. Here na macha nini, sorry. What does that mean? It means the power of God in them is no more. So they are just nothing. Nothing. And nothing. Before the eyes of the Lord Almighty. So that's what happened to the Israelites. After sinning, when you see me, I'm going to find a end. I'm going to find a end. Take out of the Midianites. No fire. When I want no answer, you guys know what is happening. But you know, Mungu is going to because Mungu is going to be isn't it? Hapo na kuna watu wanawatesa sana. Watu wanataka kama nikutesa. Bwana watesa mpaka wanataka ku. And the Lord appeared. And this man called Gideon. Tusome the book of Kings. The other name of Gideon is Jerubal. Jerubal, isn't it? Nikifu kama hiyo. Jerubal. So Mungu akashuka. Akamuliza, akaanza kuangalia. Ni nani anaweza tumia in this area? Anaitwa transformation and reformation. Tumbe ya anointed one. You know the Lord that we serve is a merciful God. Mungu hawezi kuacha tu completely. Amen. Naona kuna watu wanalia. Someone is crying his or her heart. Nani alikuwa na anointing na ikaenda? Ana feel is not there. Lift your hand. The angel of God are weaknesses. They are weakness in you. Amen. Nani anafikiria alikuwa anaomba mpaka anaongea na Mungu face to face, but now it's not there.
One, two.
Okay. See, you know I'm going to say that because some people will judge you, yeah? Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
The reason behind it is sin. Okay, then the book of Revelation chapter 2. In a sermon, I gave you time to repent, but you failed to repent. You still playing harlotry with your body. And now, I've tricked you. ceases to leave you abandoned in a sick bed.
This is my man. Hey, that year, that period of crazy expired.
Expect a sick bed. So let us not allow the devil to strike us to that level. Amen.
Amen.
We are not allowing that level to come upon us. Because this is the time of repentance. The time of holiness and righteousness. In truth and in spirit. So we want to understand. When the Lord called this person to save the land of Israel from this mess, this man came with 32,000 people to go and battle the Midianites.
But look what Gangalia has said, no. 22,000 you mean? So you know that story?
Mm. Sister Soma to me, because you know that story, time is over.
Yeah? Well, sometimes you have to give you a. You have to give you a. You have to give you a. You have to give
you
a. No. Full time in this temple, you have to give you a. Am I thinking the same? What do you mean, then?
Yeah. You're not a millionaire, you have.
No, it's God who takes people out of wilderness.
So, Gideon anapatiwa kanisa. Na hiyo kanisa inajaa washirika 30,000. Gideon akona he's a boss. Yeah? Aliangalia wana hapa fungu la 10 na sadaka. Well, I'm shifting from Sinai to Kare. Through the eyes of Gideon. But Mungu akaangalia akasema no. Your eyes are not like my eyes. These people are many. Slash them. 10,000 dropped.
Okay, back in 22,000. You know, you
can say, you're not going to be able to do it. You can say, you're not going to be able to do it. I'm telling you. Is that true? Yeah? You're not going to be able to do it. Amen? It is God. No, I don't need those people. See, people are saying, "Come on, you know, I'm going to have a guy. I'm going to have a guy. Isn't it? But people are going to say, man, no. And you know, sometimes you may think that it's God, it's demons, or it's witches who are chasing people out of the church. No, if that church is prophetic, it can never be shaken. Because anything prophetic has a prophetic covering. If there's any prophecy in you, it can never be shaken. Let me tell you. Because any prophecy released has a divine covering in it. That's why he was saying, they had a prophetic covering. Isn't it? Now the Lord was doing this not because Gideon was fasting. It's not Gideon that was fasting. He was winnowing. Isn't it? Yes, I'm fasting. I'm going to prepare. I tell him that God. No. Not because Gideon was holy. He was not holy. Why? Because in his father's house there was a demon. Or a genie. Wow. What do I get to tell you? Do just prayers, isn't it? Yes, but what a family and a demon that nyumba and Ishinai. His father was a witch. That's why I'm a Christian. I'm a people. You're a Baal. You're a Baal. You're a Baal. What does it do, sir? Yeah, what do I have for the research? You're a Baal is a demon. It's a paganistic demon. Imagine one go and get a Ujawi. Baka Baba Yao and our Ujawi is a Baal. I'm a Saul Baba Yao. So Mungu anaangalia Gideon sababu anakupatia ministry. Sometimes it doesn't take 40 days of fasting and prayer to receive from God. It takes a prophecy that was passed in your life. So what about 22? Gideon anaona, wow, ingawa washirika wangu wamepungua, hawa 22 bado ni wengi. Mungu anamwambia, no, I don't want the 22,000 members in that church. God is there, he's everywhere. But God is everywhere, but no, I'll do it my way. And when my time comes, you'll not even fast. I'll just look at my prophetic records and do it at my own time, in my own way. Why was God doing that? The Lord was doing that so that glory and honor be returned back to God. You know, when the mathematics of God's blessings comes in your life, you can never discern this mathematics by any mathematical theory that has been ever discovered by the sons of men in the field of science. Why? Because mathematics is what defines science. In a way that mtu aezi sema ni yeye alikupatia. In a way that washirika waezi sema au unanunulia pastor nyumba. In a way that hata kile kazi nilifanya yezi sema hiyo nilimtengenezea nyumba in the village. Why? Because it is the Lord who is doing it. Yes, when you want to bless you with a wife, with a husband, for example, Tony is not married yet. Yes, when you want to bless me with a wife, you will give me a wife without vibes. Without telling her, wow, you see me, I'm educated. Yes, I know that I have a dash. I'm going to bless you with a dash. No. He wants to do it in a way that you don't understand. That's how the blessings of God come. The blessing of God can never be discerned by the wisdom of sons of men. He said that you'll drive a Mercedes and you're a pastor. Don't come to church and say, God, I've been serving for 20 years and my church is not growing. What is happening? No, that is not yours. Your work is minister to him faithfully. Don't mix yourself up. Am I making sense? Our church is not growing, God, this is a curse. There is a witch at the corner of that. No! It's not that witch who said that that church to be launched or to start. It's God. And he who started a good job in you shall finish it. And once the doors of heaven are open, no one can shut them. Amen. So I'm not afraid. I'll just do what the Lord has told me to do. Yes, I'll go to that church. Even if it will take 20 years without any addition of any member, I will still go to that church because that's where my heart is and that's where the Lord directed me to go. Before I went to that church, I fought with my husband, I fought with my father, I fought with my family, I fought with my relatives so that I go to that church. And now that I'm in that church, I'm not going to be shaken. I will stand with that in that church in poverty and in riches. I will be there. That's the heart that the Lord seeks to bless. Am I making sense to someone? So here comes Gideon. He was winnowing. He was not praying. He was not giving tithes or offerings or altars. But he experienced an angelic ministry, an angelic visitation. Let me tell you, breakthroughs and miracles happens through angelic ministry. You know, the Holy Spirit can never give you a cut. Do you know that? Let me tell you, from today, come on, back on a bear, wrong relative, anybody again. That is foolishness. Because the Holy Spirit is not involved and does not care about material things. He is a holy spirit, and these material things are defiled. Amen? So is it material things? What happens when it comes to material things? Education, me, wife, getting a wife, a husband, a car. It takes an angelic ministry. Okay, that's why you can say, oh, it's a malaika. Malaika Gabriel. No, not a guy. Isn't it? Because a malaika is a kiss. I'm like, what a malaika is a kiss. It's not a guy. Never a line. Let a line here with you. It's not to define the principality of tongues. It's not a guy. Isn't it? It's not a line. That's not a word after a row. I'm going to direct. They are never waiting. Do you know that? And that's what discovery. Kuna another ministry called angelic ministry. So that when you're touched by the Holy Spirit, know about the material breakthrough. Eh? Yeah, it's strange, eh? What else if you say?
Amen.
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 Am I making sense?
Yes.
School of Prophet Shapa in Genology, the study of angels. Yes? By the grace of God. So, Roa Moon, Anga is up to the belly and give you. Like anyone like our Moon is at the belly and give you. Roho wa Mungu angeweza kupromote Naaman
angeza kupromote Nebukadneza. Na angeza kuachilia Waisraeli kwa mikono za Nebukadneza. But malaika wa Mungu. Is that true? Roho wa Mungu angeza tawala wana wa Israeli from the, in the wilderness. Because he was too holy. No one was qualified. Walikuwa mpaka na knowledge ya kutengeneza miungu na waziabudu. Si ndio? Kama roho wa Mungu angewaongoza, wangekufia wote kwa wilderness. Because we had that is the sweet of God that is holiness to the highest level. Is it? But malaika wa Mungu alifanya hiyo kazi. The pillar of fire during the night and smoke during the day. That's why we need an angelic ministry in this church. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Sasa leo tunaanza kuona watu wanapona, watu wanatembea. Huyo si malaika wa Mungu, hiyo ni malaika wa Mungu. Ana minister. Ama naongea mambo ingine ile mjui. Kama mjijua leo. Bwana asifiwe sana.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So roho wa Mungu anatembelea Gideon. Na kwa kina Gideon kuna jini. Na roho wa Mungu anatembea kwa Gideon. Anaambia Gideon, chukua panga, enda ukataka hawa watu watawatesa. So Gideon anachukua panga, anaenda na watu 22. What about the 3,300? Now 300 Mungu anasema, na wapunguza ndio usiseme ni nguvu zako zilipigana. Mungu anatupunguza sometimes this charge. So that tusiseme, ni sadaka yetu inafanya pastor anaishi. Amen.
Amen.
Mungu asangida na kutasenda na tunashinda kutoa sadaka na kutoa tempo. So that we say, wewe unanisha pastor. Tuna hiyo kuja hapa na suti sasa wewe ndio umetumwa. Ni bora asifike sana. Yeah, because when God blesses, he wants his glory and honor to be returned back to him. He can never share his glory with anyone. Never ever. So if you're a man of God, expect blessings from God that will not be shared by anyone. So here comes Gideon. He's remaining with 300 men. But, before that ministry to materialize to the fullest, he was to do something. Yet the angel of God is directing you. You still need the Spirit of God. Bwana asifiwe. Ndio sasa hivi ndio mbingo ndio afisa wa Mungu ana maana. Sasa kwanza leo ni malaika gani? Malaika tao. Roho Mungu atakupeleka kwa malaika, atakupeleka kwa malaika hili. Wewe malaika wa giza umeja hapa. Umeja. Wengine wale umeja hapa juu ni wengi. Bwana asifiwe sana. So, Mungu anabadilisha sababu this man still needs the Holy Spirit. Because angels sometimes can mislead you, because even the angel of darkness can come and minister to you.
Amen. Amen.
So when you pray today, pray God, fill you with your spirit. So that he directs angels from God to minister unto me. That's why after Christ fasted and prayed in spirit for 40 days, the angels of God came to minister unto him after he defeated Satan thrice. So I'm just so marvelous in the book of the Gospels. Simeni soma hapo. Kwa gaya kwa Matthew, isn't it? Simeni soma hapo wae. Matthew chapter 4. Soma hapo. When I feel it. I said this what happened. So malaika wa Mungu. Let me tell you. How cults are formed. Ujua kuna watu wengine, Mungu kuja na wanaemeza. Hata wanetia malaika real. Real from heaven. Ambe malaika hindo saidi ule. So huyo mtu anaingia kwa ministry. Malaika wa Mungu alimtembelea. Ni ukweli ni malaika wa Mungu alimtembelea. So anaambia through angelic ministry. Alafu akiminista hapo, malaika anakadiri ile kazi ameambiwa. Huyu mtu anasahau kutafuta Roho Mtakatifu. Roho Mtakatifu utafutwa. Apatikanagi tu hivyo. Malaika unzampara tu hivyo. Because they are ministering spirit like us. Mungu anazalisha grace ya malaika. But as it is grace ya Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit must be sought. You know that? Yeah, kuna watu wengine wanzisha kanisa through angelic spirit, angelic ministry. Wanafanya miracle, isn't it? Si tunaona kwa TV. Wanachukua mafimbo za Musa na wanahubiri injili kwa kwamba kuna mtu ameokoka kweli. Anafanya usharati hapa na anafanya miracle hapa. No, is this man real? Na ukweli anahubiri kabisa na endaje kwa mganga. But akitoka kwa pulpit anafanya the opposite of what he was doing. You my niche, some people, some of them. See what they worship, my people. They worship the real angels of God. So, this angel of God is like a period of grace. Your period of grace is just be back to heaven, isn't it? So it's like back to heaven. The angel of darkness in our life. That's just to feed that space. So the end of that person is worse than the beginning. That's how cults are formed. So now my is not for me of a different. Yes, this is the Bible. It's true. But they converted. So this is what happened. Mungu aliona hii kitu. Nimepatia Gideon an angelic ministry. But this person needs a helper. Because angels, kazi ya malaika ni kufanya miracle. Na kusaidia kufungua magate, Peter akishikwa, ya, kuleta maji. Bali kuna deserts kuleta maji, zinafanya. Zile vitu Musa alikuwa anafanya miracles. Zile zilikuwa angels kwa anafanya hiyo kazi. Malaika walikuwa anafanya that job. But for you to fellowship with God, so that you be filled by God, your characters, your discipline, your thoughts, your emotions and feelings, to look like Christ-like. Read the Holy Spirit. And for that Holy Spirit to come upon you, this is what you have to do. Judges chapter 6, verse 25 and 27. And it came to pass the same night that the Lord said to him, take your father's young bullock, even the second bullock of 7 years old, and throw down the altar of Baal that your father has, and cut down the groove is by it. Let us continue. And build an altar to the Lord. You see, if you want your fire back, you must repair your altar. You know, sometimes we repair our altars. Think about them to the back to the same lifestyle that used to live. Why? Because even if you break your parent altar today, your parent is not dead, it's still alive. There's something that is still doing in the village without your knowledge. So you have to rebuke it, destroy it seasonally until you make it. Am I making sense? Yeah. Your parent is still your parent. I go back to the village. Yeah? And about your advice, fanya hivi ndio mtoto wako aoe. Fanya hivi ndio mtoto wako akae kwa ndoa. Fanya hivi ndio mtoto wako afanye hii. Fanya hivi ndio mtoto wako akusaidie. Isn't it? Those are the altars that were raised. For those altars must be destroyed. As they raise them, you destroy them. As they raise them, you destroy them. So mbona mwambia, ndio yu ministry nimekupatia. Ndio malaika nimekupatia wa kusaidie. But, go back to your father's house. Sometimes, you have to go back to your father's house. And when you see, when that name father is mentioned, yes, I'm seeing your uncle, I'm seeing your auntie, I'm seeing your relatives. If you know that these people are very important, watch a mmoja yake kwa devil worship. We throw sacrifice our way. You will all die in that home, isn't it? So any altar that is raised by your cousin is directly connected to you. Come and seek way to. Ay. Na biega mbuni mfabilikene ni mbeta. Kari. Nige kwa huko mbuni nyo na yonu familia na kuja. Sige, ya. Because tuko katikati, isn't it? Na huko ni altar, gome, so we are fighting, eh? Boo, 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 boo. Why? Because these people are altar-oriented people. Kina mwezi. You bad. Na huko ni mwezi ni kwa waganga. Madawa za kutekeleza, bwana fukwetu mjumping site ya mapepo, isn't it? Because you don't go to magicians, yeah? So how do you wear that? Because you're jumping inside, you want to throw her up. So something funny, when I say, wana ngojaka tukufe lakini waki. Or they want to go high. I want to be machawi, yeah? Now we never accuse them of being witches, yeah? This is what I'm thinking, you know, because either we don't even associate with them. What we need to say, wana ngojaka tukufe lakini waki. Yeah, that's it, that's it. Una to money prudena, you know, we let too savage to live with. But that's a good thing. Do you know that the altars that they make, they are directly connected to us because we are their relatives? Do you know that?
Yes.
But that's a good thing. So don't think that breaking an altar, you broke it last year, you are free now, completely. No. You only break from that day, Uko Yoma. That's why you're here, but I'm going to make a praise. And that's why we are a living war. And we have to raise altars as many times as we can for us to be free in Jesus' name. Amen. Since Adam sinned, religion became expensive. What has it for you? Gideon, go with these 300 men. But before you go, break that
father's altar that is in your house. So he's going. When he went to that battle, the Lord told him, we don't need to fight these people, but just shout the God of Gideon and the Lord of my ancestors, and you see that battle won. And that's what happened. Elijah, the fire is extinguished during the contest at Mount Carmel. And Elijah discovered that for the fire to be rekindled again, I've got to repair it. And they repaired the altar of God Almighty. And the fire from heaven came and fell upon the altars. And the prophets of Baal were slain, more than 400. Is it 400? What has the few said?
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Am I making sense to someone today?
Yes.
Remember that you're going to do here? You're living here?
Yes.
You know, make sense?
Yes.
What has the few? I thank God because the Lord is going to be here. I'm going to give you grace. And I thank God. What has the few?
Amen.
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 Amen. So we need to raise an altar. Who is going to raise an altar? Who is going to raise an altar? What has the few? Let me tell you. Let me tell you what else. I told you, and I'm reminding you with this. You know, this church in Africa is a kidogo sana, isn't it? Ebusu moja pastor akuja asimame hapa aseme, now from today, hii kanisa imeisha. From next Sunday, ataka kanisa, mtu anamje mtakojeka, my answers, my chumba, my grum. Mgina unapula mashingo, kwa machura, isn't it? Kwa sasa kini, tunatana wiki, tunapia kuja ni mapema, mnakosa, mnasamea kanisa gani, isn't it? Ebusu moja tunatua, now this church is not there. Ndi utajua kwa ni this church is important to your life. Don't think that connecting yourself to another church, alafu kuja upate network, kama hii ni rahisi. Naambia ngo try. Try. Mimi naweza kupatia time ya kutry. Jaribu kutoka hapo uende kanisa nyingine hata for 3 months. Uende ndo rudi hapa pia. Because getting that connection is not easy. And this church, I normally tell you people, is a multi-billion investment. It's a multi-billion
investment.
Once you're here, you have employed yourself. It's true. Amen.
Amen.
Niliona juzi nganga akiongea somewhere. Anasema wao jungaji wa bishop hawa. Walikuwa rukaruka kwa madibau yangu na matuta. Isn't it? Saa hii wako na magari. Saa hii unaweza rukaruka hapa na matuta. But kesho utakuwa na gari. From this pulpit that unaiona kama chwara chwara. Hiyo ndio kile nilishika kabisa kwa hiyo testimony. Kwa hiyo mambo ni ongea kwa hiyo nilisikia hiyo na nikafunga hiyo sikia na sikia. Bwana asifiwe sana. So it's very serious. So let us come together in unison and build this church. Because once you are building this church, you are building yourself. Ni kweli? Is it true? So let us not take these things lightly. Sasa tunasema tunaomba kujeni kanisa mapema. Kujeni fellowship on Saturday. Kuna bwana mtu mmoja anakuja. I'm telling you people that the investment that 90% of us have is in this church. Mimi kama Tony Maima, investment yangu 100% is in this church. Because this is where I was called to minister. Is that true?
Yes.
Now, I will be paid according to my work. Nikizuba moto iende. Kwisha, I'll fail in life. But nikiweka hiyo moto ikue, that fire must burn. That fire will bring resources. And I will prosper. For it is wrong. It's wrong seeing your fire is extinguished because of grudges and forgiveness. You have to repair your altar. Repairing your altar means forgiveness. Yes, forgiving those who offend you, loving those who hate you, coming to church early and pray about it. Don't complain about it, but pray about it. God will just give us way of connecting ourselves in peace and unity. We are not here as an accident. I'm not going to answer the chairs. This is a multi-billion ministry.
Ndio kuna vingine wanasema kanisa ni biashara, isn't it? Na mbe kama unataka kanisa ni biashara, sema fungue biashara za kanisa hapo nje mimi. Yeah, waone. Bwana asifiwe. So this is God's business, not human business, but God's business. And once you are in this farm of God, He will take care of your old age. You will not depend on your children as you think. You will not depend on your husband or wife. You will depend on God. And that will determine in your commitment. Commit your ways unto the Lord, and it shall come to pass. And this commitment is and must start by repairing your altar. See, I'm going to talk about a ministry. Niko na ministry ya giving, niko na ministry ya prophecy, niko na ministry ya uimbaji. Na unaona hiyo ministry ina lack, ina mzubaa, ina tapa tapa. That means there is something wrong with you. You have to repair that altar for that fire of God to come and burn that ministry or that altar that you have raised before the Lord. Any ministry is an altar raised in the spiritual realm. And that altar can never be powerful without fire. Just like we give to a ministry, like Cain had a ministry, Abel had a ministry. Cain had a Abel in a worker and a worker and a Abel. And if I had a Peter, say, come somewhere in the land of Nod. That is stupidity, isn't it? But now we come here, you say, pardon me, I keep a worker and language a worker. I'm so gay. I'm but here advice. I'm a Mumba could you have a card that you come back? Yeah? Who's an Abel and a Cain? Come on, you can't do a reconcile, isn't it? Mumba could you come back and have a card? Because the Lord that we serve is a meat eater. They are never warning. We have to support each other ministry, each other altar, for the power of God to come and lead our altars. There is a reason why we are connected. I can't do without Pastor Washington. Pastor Washington can't do without me. Pastor can't do without Tom. Tom can't do without... It's just like that. You know, Jana, I was very much moved. Because in the end of my life, tulikuwa kwa seminar flani. And it is a testimony. Yeah, the founder of that ministry. I was moved. I was very much moved. This person, Aliyaza Kanisa, through social media, Mungu alimuitia hapo. Isn't it? Yeye akasema yeye atakufungua ministry, online ministry. So pia online ministry, ala washirika, kuna mtu wa kuministry, kuna mtu wa watu wajui. The way we do it in just prayers. Amen? So out of that, akafungua theological school. Isn't it? Yeye ana watu, but amefungua theological school. That is a pastor. Ni msomi kweli kweli. Isn't it? And this theological school, imeshika watu, maina leta watu. Na mtu akikuja anapata congregation ya watu, more than 500 people. Na inaendelea ku grow, isn't it? Yeah? Na ameandika watu kazi out of it, bila kutoa hata pesa. Yeah, anaandika mtu kazi, na watu wanaangalia kazi in that ministry. Why? Because of the fire. In that altar is always burning. Now, I'm going to preach theologically. I'm going to sing like theology. But when I want to preach a minister, when I want to preach a minister, I'm going to take a lot of people very gay and very green. Come on, by theology. You know, that's all I said. But through the sample, we don't want to have miracles. We don't want to have miracles. We don't want to have miracles. Through the sample of the people that he ministered to, when he say, in Jesus' name, get healed. When they were invited, they were going to say, amen. In a connect na yema deno, in a truly, in a thing, I'm going to have a miracle. And that person never fast the way you fast. Because God told me, I'm going to go to the house. Amen. He's just trusting in what the Lord has given you. And say, the Lord Almighty, I'll make sure that the fire in this altar is burning. Hey, mercy, just press your point fire. And of course, our vision is fire in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And it takes your effort. Amen.
Amen.
Okay, when your pastor at your end of the Mzungu akubariki, it will never happen. To look at Mzungu, to go with Mzungu, since you are African, I can only say Mzungu, you're that man. Tell me the Mzungu, more than a person. No, Mzungu, I'm going to say, my partner. Kama ni bora pesa tukikuwa nchi yetu, nimekuja hapa because of poverty. Si alisema hivyo leo alikuwa huko. Bwana asifiwe. So that mzungu amekuja bowed down to that man. Fara fara that man vile si fara na wazungu saa ingine. So yule mzungu anafanya hivi that man. Bwana asifiwe. And that man never uses money to run his ministry. Yes, that is theological school. Na watu wanakuja watu wanajui. Now the computer should connect. That's how God works. So don't play with your ministry. You will watch your mother in Aisha. It's because you are sitting in it. You are expecting your pastor. You are waiting for your pastor to bless you. No, you are supposed to help your pastor to shine. For the blessings that are in him to be transferred to you. Because you have make sure that his fire, his altar, is burning. Who's going to raise an altar? Next Sunday, are you doing it?
Yes.
Altar service. So this one. The Lord is directing me to do this. I'm sorry. But we have to clarify. But pastor will clarify about that, yeah? Come up with a matter to clarify. But this is what I plan to do. By the Holy Spirit. By the help of the Holy Spirit, we are going for a fast. And this fast is connecting us to the Holy Spirit. And tell God, forgive us. To be what we will can send to Kikwazana. To Kichukiana. Mtu anakuja hapa anahubiri, anahubiri grudge. Bwana asifiwe. Toma akimwambia cut, atakasirika. Mwingine amekaa huko nyuma, anaona mwingine ako hapa anahubiri. Akihubiri mwingine ako huko nyuma analaani huyo ako hapa mbele, anasema huyu anaongeanga nini, usi atakakae. Anadharau mpaka huyu mtu ako hapa akimwambia simama asimami. Omba aombi. Amen. Hizo ndio tunafanya fire in us inaisha. Now we want the fire in us to meet again.
Amen.
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 So we are going into a repentance session. Every week. And we'll be fasting. A quarter fast is okay, isn't it? The one of us from Sayamusha Mugula is Satana Yapsi. From Satana Yapsi. Like if you can sit a pump, you start your fast. No water, no anything. Mpaka kesho yake saa sita ya mchana. Is that okay? Is it okay?
Yes.
Hey, tunambia Mungu tusamehe, tusamehe. Unajua kuna maugonjwa zingine hukuja kwa mwili because of grudges, some hatred. Maugonjwa zinakatambia kwa mwili, ya? Tunambia Mungu tusamehe. Kama hii ugonjwa inakuja because of grudge, forgive me. Kama hii ugonjwa inakuja because unajua kuna Biblia inasema amlaaniwaye yoyote afanyaye kazi ya Mungu kwa ulegevu. Kama kuna mahali ulifanya kazi ya Mungu kwa ulegevu, Mungu nisamehe. And nilikuwa na announce Basiltika from our WhatsApp group that from this Sunday I'll be coming here kuanzia saa moja. It was at 6. We have to rekindle the fire. You remember how you used to pray in Stanjo? Nataka tuanze kukuja kanisani by saa moja sharp ya here. I thank God because wengine waliona hiyo kitu na wakakuja. Kuzi ngoje pastor announce vitu zingine. Sometimes we have good things to help our pastor grow. Sisi ndio tunafanya pastor na kuwa drag behind. Ndiyo sasa hivi pasta anaenda anaenda huko nje na ulizo. Kanisa yako ina grow. Ana shida hapo hivi. Why? Because kazi ya pasta si kufanya kanisa i grow. Mchungaji asa iko ndo. Kondo zako ndo. Kama mimi sikuwa pasta na leta mtu hapa. Never. Na hata wewe leta mtu hapa ndio ukimuuliza. Ana kwambia I don't remember whom I ever told to come in this church. Sisi unaweza watu tutawapatia mchungaji. Is that true? So it's not the pastor is not sleeping. It is us who are sleeping. Now if you sleep in the church, you tap a curse. You listen. Umewahi tatani in church. I was connected to Mama Mwendwa. Mama Mwendwa connected me to Mama Mia. Amefanya kazi ya Bwana, si ndio? Unajua siku moja Mungu anakuza wewe uliokoka, uliyo tatani kwa salvation. Rose, I was connected to Rose Nanga. Rose akaleta Mama Dick. Yeye ni kazi amefanya, isn't it? Amen.
Amen.
What about us? Who more did I need church? It's because your fire is not lit. Do you expect any salary from God? So you have to rekindle this fire. You have to be moved. Sasa. Enough is enough. And you have to be coming to church very early in the morning. I'll not be repeating this. No, you're not going to have to answer. So whoever have ears, let him hear what the Spirit is doing what? And you're the only man who has a book. Nikajipata nimechelewa. Hey. Nikasema nini kuingia kwa bafu kuoga na kuvaa kama vikashu. Leo nimevaa t-shirt leo. Na kutoka na nikaa because nilikuwa nimesema by saa moja I have to be here. Na nataka tujicommit in that way.
Yes, the Lord has been telling me these things. That I'm really committed to other churches, other ministries, Kila Sana Itwa, Kila Sana Instagram Media. Then our church is leading. No, that is not the way. Nanika, two bullying up there, Mugunisame. Kumbe kufanya, kukaka kanisa na ulegevu, inatap a curse from it. So next Sunday, tunakuja hapa, raise an altar. Ya kwambia, now, we want the fire back. Mambe kukuja kanisani saa tano, tuna repent. Who's ready to repent? Do you know that it is sin to come to church Saturday? Do you know that it is sin? Hey, we are coming to repent on Sunday. To the repent. We'll be coming to church very early in the morning. On Sundays. We'll be giving our Sundays unto you. On Saturdays, we'll be coming to our fellowships. Could not begin at our Jaika Nyagata one Saturday. How do you expect the Lord to bless you? If you want your fire back, then you must repair your altar. Don't just come to church and go. Come to church to get something from God Almighty. And it shall be well with him. Let us stand. Oh, dear Lord, have grace. Be magnified, be glorified. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Bakolo bakase berese bekele bosoto rohosi. Arebe kelo bakase bereto rohosi bekele baso bolosi. Arebe kelo bokose binese bekele bese bakalo bosi bekele. Basi.
Yeah.
I'm seeing you. I'm seeing that you are working somewhere in a supermarket. Na in that supermarket, okona cheo. Na kazi yako iko huko nyuma, unafaa uko kwa computer. But unatoka huko nyuma, unakuja na gitaa, unakaa kwa mlango wa supermarket. Unaanza kucheza gitaa. Tutajiona tuko hapa nje, mimi na Nora tuko hapa nje tunakuangalia. Na inafaa niende kufanya roadwork nikimbia huko nje. But lazima sasa kujimbia hata kuangalia vile basi la worship. So as you are worshiping, the boss in that supermarket ako very unruly. But then like you supposed to save your boss, then like any kama yako, kwa sababu akikufikia hata uattack barara kuogoka. That you are busy playing guitar, una play guitar very perfect. But all of us had it. Naona kuna Leila anakuja na vitu kwa box. Ni kama anakuja kwa kwa sababu yake kumuguzi. Alafu anafika mahali. Ni kama ana give up, ana rudi na hiyo box. Alafu una change, unakuwa mnark kama makaa. Alafu imeishi hapo. Do you know what is that? Who can translate that? You need to make your fire burn. You need to make your altar. But because now you're in a vanisha, una kazi, but unataka kuingia kwa full time ministry. Isn't it? Because of his yako is over human. But you want to come into full time ministry. You want to play guitar, you are serving God in a guitar. You are praising God. That means roho yako imejitolea. Kama roho ya Daudi. But I'm seeing Lila is coming in that supermarket, la vitu kwa box. But akufiki, ana change, anabadilika, ana rudi pali ametoka. Alafu anakuwa black, wewe unakuwa black. Unakuwa black kama hivyo hivyo. Nani hivyo hivyo vile inakaa? That's how your skin looks like. That means the heart is willing, but your body is weak. Kuna hindrances. Maybe kuna vitu unasikia, kuna vitu unaona, kuna udaku inatoka from any source. Hebu just sit down for a minute, please. This is very important. Let me tell you, the Lord is warning me to tell you this. From today, kama kuna mshirika atakuja kwa nyumba yako, kwa kanisa, kukuletea mdaku, inahusiana na kanisa. rebuke that demon in that person. Don't rebuke that person, but rebuke that demon. Amen. Mambo ya kanisa ni shaka kanisani. Na kama inakuuma ama unataka kujua zaidi, kuja kwa viongozi wa kanisa. We have viongozi in this church. Amen. Don't dare try to go there, outside there, and discuss anyone in this church with anyone in this church. This thing has been killing us. Amen?
Amen.
Am I making sense?
Yes.
Because sasa unasikia hiyo kitu, wewe ndio unasikia na wewe unasema mtapata the same curse. Kata kusikia any negative thing from this church. Kama kuna issue, kuja kwa Pastor Tom, Pastor Tom anapeleka Pastor Washington. That's what we do. Do you know that Washington, Pastor Washington is my shemeji. Pastor Thomas is my shemeji also. But you know that huko nje tunaongea na mtu za kawaida. We talk, we do everything. But when it comes to things of this church, I don't go to him directly. I pass through Pastor Tom. Respect. Hapa ni kanisani. Mambo ya ushemeji, ya relative, ya nini hakuna. Hapa we are all children of God. Hakuna ukabila, sivyo ati wewe ni hii, wewe ni mrengo hii, wewe ni Jubilee, wewe ni NS. No, we don't do that. Hapa we the only purpose of our existence in this place is Jesus Christ. Amen.
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 So any person who comes to talk in against any member, against any family in this church, in your house, you have to rebuke that demon. Or else you tap that curse or you share that curse. Ima boya muna kaa muna ongea about people in the church. Is it here? Kama umewe experience, ino mkono juu. Enu kuna dhabi zingine watu wamekatalia. Okay, good. Good. Iyo imeishi hapo from today. In Jesus' name I cancel that.
Amen.
Kama unatembelea. Kama unatembelea hiyo dada hiyo ndugu. Ongea na yeye mambo ya usia na kanisa ama mambo ile ya kidunia ya mko kwa village. But most importantly, mambo ya kanisa, because it's the church that imetuweka together. Issues za church, wacha ziishie church. Kama tuna issues, leteni kwa viongozi, we sort it out through the direction of the Holy Spirit and we forget about it. Anytime when a pastor stands here and preach, please make sure that you preach what the Holy Spirit is directing you to preach. Don't preach about someone. Don't talk with the intention of hitting someone if the Holy Spirit is not directing you to do that. Amen.
Amen.
And sometimes I preach sermons that synagogue are watu. Is that true? Yeah, mpaka mtu anasema huyu jamaa ananiongea, alinisikia somewhere, in Kenya. Yeah? But at the end of the day, tunakuwa tuna marafiki. Why? Because the Spirit of God is indirect. I'm not speaking about you. I'm speaking what the Spirit of God is telling me to speak. Mpana asifiwe. Hata ukiona makosa kwa mtu, hata ukiona ndoto kwa mtu, don't go to that person directly. Uwambe uliyota, uliyota. Are you a prophet? Hata ukiona prophecy, sagino unaiona, don't go to that person directly. Because you don't have the knowledge and the wisdom to deliver it to that person. Keep quiet, bring it to the leaders. So you have a pastor here?
Yes.
Iende huko, iyo mambo yanzie from top to bottom. But okay, ukianzia kwa chini utaharibu kila kitu. So the spirit of gossip is destroyed in this church in Jesus' name.
Amen.
A gossiper has no problem, but that spirit that is in him or her is the reason behind all this problem that we are facing. Amen.
Amen.
You see, I'm seeing Basil. Anatana kwa hii. Hii si kala mzuri. Do you know that the black color is the color of darkness? Na nuna Basil amechikomita, ametoka na gitaa na imba. But hiyo grace inatoka. Why is it that the grace is coming out of your life? Leila, the grace is coming out of you. Why? Basil, is it true that you feel the grace coming out of you? Is it true?
Yeah.
You feel the grace coming out because of the things you hear. Because of the things you hear. Unajua mtu kama mimi sasa hivi nimefika hata nisikie nini. Una ndusi ya asubuhi, hiyo ya asubuhi ni kwa hapa ipreach. But ndio wengine wetu bado hajafika hiyo level. Ukimwambia tu kitu kidogo asikii, ana withdraw. Na okay, withdraw, you tap a curse immediately. Do you know that if you withdraw, you tap a curse? So basically, you need to repent and tell God. When are you in there? Then, did you have a baby? I will need to repent. I can't force you to repent. Dependent, did you force yourself to repent? But before I proceed, is it to now care? Is it out of my mind? Am I out of my mind? Or they are real? You can say, I'm going to repent, I'm going to repent, I'm going to repent, I'm going to repent, isn't it? There is that ministerial fire in you guys, in like were extinguished. So, you are in this, you are in the ministry, with your might and strength and knowledge, not us, but what the Lord deposited in you. You in the end, but you can call it back, no repentance. Now, God is talking about you because he loves you. They don't want you guys to minister. So am I making sense? Are you sure? Don't just say yes to impress me. Whoever God loves, he rebukes. Okay, now raise your hands. To the Lord Jesus.
I know
that I will fall many times. But I'll be standing as I fall. Because you never leave me. Don't forsake me. Use me as you promised to use me. If I've been doing your job in slumber, out of gossip that I heard from people, forgive me! Forgive me! Forgive me! And make your fire to be lit upon me again. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray and believe. Amen. And the angels are the witness in this session that I've just passed. May we receive your ministry once again. Receive your fire once again. And may the Lord give you the bold heart and spirit to stand in his ministry. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray and believe. You may be seated. Let me tell you, people, once the Lord is using you, you must be bold. Amen? So that you stand. Because what the Lord has given you a ministry, alafu juu ya vita na udaku ufanye utoke, you tap a curse. Mungu ataangalia, it's because of the woman you gave me. And because of the woman I gave you, God will hear and fight the wrath of your demons. What the ministry is upon you. If you mess it out, the Lord will mess you out. In Jesus' name, may you receive it.
Amen.
Those who have ears, let them hear what the Spirit is telling. Let us stand. And in the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Before I conclude, tomorrow, next weekend, we'll be at the altars, we'll do it, we'll pray about it. Maybe pastor will stress that, man, die. So, you know how we do our altars, I don't have to dwell on that. Yeah? So let me release this blessing. Now, in the mighty name of God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, and may the Lord keep you.
Amen.
And may the Lord promote you.
Amen.
Praise and worship of God. Makolo, makase, derese, delese, obokote, reese. Okay. And may the Lord keep you.
Amen.
And may the Lord prosper you.
Amen.
And may the Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you.
Amen.
And may you receive peace.
I receive.
Peace.
I receive.
In your life, peace.
I receive.
In your ministry, peace.
I receive.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Receive it.
I receive.
Receive it.